Why don't you go to the dentist?
White coat syndrome.
White coat syndrome. That's a new one. And maybe it's just fear of the dentist with a fresh coat of paint, but I don't like going to the dentist. I don't do well. I have the pain tolerance of a toddler. But I know that I gotta. And I know that I wasn't able to for so many years when I just did not have insurance.
Yeah.
I remember hearing, I think I brought this up before, and on his way up before the fall and then the, I don't know, leveling out of his career, Dane Cook came on a program around these parts years ago and said that he knew he made it when he could afford to go to the dentist. That was the first thing, but I think he was asked, how did you know that new album, Harmful of Swallowed, followed up by, I think it was Annihilation. How did you know you made it? Was it the money? Was it the New York Times write-up? He said, I got a tooth fixed.
Yep.
That's a big deal for a lot of people.
Yeah, it is.
You don't have that health insurance, that dental insurance?
That's why, like, I've done a lot of work to my teeth now while I can, because I don't know, you know, who knows? Here today, gone tomorrow, we could be, you know, blown out.
I'm paying the tab for years of bad living.
Yeah, I did too, and I've gotten it to a good spot right now. This is a weird one. Tex says, I didn't go for 17 years. Dentist in my youth punched me and yelled at me.
Jeez Louise. I mean, Josh, you have every reason to not want to go to the dentist based on what you told us from so long ago.
What happened? Sorry you brought it up, fella.
Take it away.
Kid. Well, to make a short story long, I went to the orthodontist when I was a kid. He hated me because I didn't take care of my teeth. I wouldn't brush my teeth, so stuff would get stuck in the braces, and he yelled at me for, oh, you're wasting your father's money.
Fact.
And he would just lace into me. And
maybe you needed it.
Well,
just like when I didn't like going to our doctor and you couldn't understand it. I don't like him. You didn't like him. You needed to hear that.
Well, let me tell you something. Let me tell you who won
and he
that
was
battle.
Of course, you always win.
He's dead now.
Yeah, hell yeah. They found him with a Mr. Thirsty jammed in his eyeball, slurping out brain matter, hooked up to the device, just sucking pink juice
called
at him.
Tough love.
Buried under a mountain of tooth fairy teeth.
Tough love. He told you what you needed to hear. Brush your teeth.
The son of a
you
bitch.
You little, what do they call him? You little
bastard.
Rascal.
You little rat bastard. Brush your teeth. Your dad's paying good money for these braces.
I also had another dentist who was a nice guy. His name was Dr. Goody.
Oh, they're not nice.
Goodies?
Yeah.
Reach into the bag and take out a goodie.
Yeah.
Poor Stamboni had
He's
to
also
see.
Also dead.
Oh, wow. Man, you're just leaving a trail of bodies in your wake.
We start calling you the Clintons.
I can't wait until, oh no, there's a red dot on Scott's chest.
Wow, who's that's that
dude
a poll.
Who's that dude outside the
saw,
window?
I just saw something. I saw a meme the other day. Oh, it was a picture of Hillary Clinton. And they're like, doesn't everybody's 56 of everyone's friends die of suicide?
Foster. Yeah. What was his name? Not David Foster. Somebody.
Yeah. If you were in that inner circle, a lot of slip and falls. A lot of slip and falls. Hey, you want to go hang out on the edge of that skyscraper? Not really. Joe, unfortunately, had to see me. 410-338-1098. We're going to take your calls while you didn't go to the dentist. I fell down. I told you about this. It was like a year or so ago. The calculus removal videos.
Oh, yeah.
Extreme plaque removal.
Oh,
Joe,
I've
have you
seen
ever
them.
Seen these?
I
got one on screen right
yeah,
now.
Yeah, I know.
Up.
I saw.
Why don't you turn around and watch it?
Involved with that. If there was smell-o-vision,
I can't do it.
Look at the amount of... it's pure...
I can't do it.
Like... it's like removing old caulk.
This might be part of my problem. When a little kid has a loose tooth,
like the plastic,
and it's just I can't do it. It gives me like the heebie-jeebies.
Oh.
Just like a baby loose tooth. Just
anti-Semitic.
It's called scaling when they descale it. There was this one video I watched where it was the only thing that held the teeth in place were the tartar, and when he knocked it off, like five teeth just came with it. Ugh. Like Charlie Day trying to remove his teeth, little to no problems. Let's go to the phones, 410-338-1098. Alex, you are a dentist.
Morning.
I hope you're not
a dentist. I am
a dentist,
so I haven't been doing this for like 40 years. I've been doing it for like four. but I've been around long enough to see some pretty gnarly stuff.
How's your bedside manner? Because that is a big fear.
You seem weird.
Yeah, dentists are weird. Patients say I do have a pretty good bedside manner. Mm-hmm. I think I do a pretty good job kind of explaining what a crown is, what a filling is, why you need to get this tooth out. You're going to be in a hospital in 12 hours if you don't.
And not saying you...
I saw a guy a couple days ago like that.
But people of your ilk, the dentist, why do they want to have a heart-to-heart? Well, I got a mouthful of stuff. When my mouth is...
Yeah, you don't really expect a response, right? You're just kind of making small talk.
No. That is totally not me. I do not engage in conversations when I'm working. Like, no. Because when I was a kid growing up, that was a pet peeve of mine.
Yeah.
My childhood dentist. And I am not about to do that to someone.
It's like when the waitress comes to your table to ask how everything is, right when you've taken the biggest bite of food.
Very good.
Yeah. So one gnarly thing I saw was just the other day, I saw this guy who had an infection in a lower left tooth, recommended to get the tooth out, but he said it wasn't bothering him, it wasn't hurting him. Well, it wasn't bothering and hurting him because the nerve was dead in the tooth. Well, the infection spread down his neck, and then he had a baseball-sized swelling on the side of his face with a big white head on it.
Uh-huh, which is what happened
Justin
to me.
Had that.
I had to go to the hospital. Because I had this funky molar that went rotten on me, and I woke up one day with a fever. Side of my face was all puffed out. Remember, my old boss, Dave, who I have blocked, yelled at me because I had a show to do, and I called in a kid that worked in promotion to be on the air for me. I had no business doing that. And they said that had any of the infection gone up any higher, I could have lost my vision.
Yeah, there have been instances we've talked about in the news where kids they'll die because the infection goes in their brain, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, there was a 9-year-old kid in Baltimore which died from a dental infection from a front tooth. 9 years old in Baltimore City about 15 years ago. And really quickly, dental things can turn into medical situations. And before you know it, you are admitted into the ER on an IV drip and heavily sedated. And you're fighting for your life. And you get...
I need to ask my dentist, but I'm pretty sure I have an extra wisdom teeth up in my face. Is that a thing?
That is a thing that can happen sometimes.
Because I got all four pulled, but I think there's another one floating around up there, and I think it's starting to bother me.
Yeah, I would probably get that checked out, dude.
Okay.
Yeah, it was one of those things where they're like, if it's not bothering you, we're just going to leave it. But now I think it might be starting to bother me.
I think you need to get that checked out. Okay.
Dentist Alex joining us on the program.
I don't like your tone.
Yeah. Hey, do you have anything to do with the Baltimore Dental Museum?
Yeah, I went to University of Maryland Dental School, which is about a block away. So, yeah, I would go there before. It's kind of cool if teeth are your thing.
Hey, did you have struggling artists? This was a big thing in comedy, and I can only imagine if we asked Stambo Music, that if you didn't have dental insurance... You could go to a dental school and be
my
a subject.
My father did that.
Justin
he got like
Schlegel
30 teeth. No joke. He got 30 teeth or something removed.
And he didn't have any teeth left.
Well, maybe 20, but he got like a lot of teeth
at
removed.
At a dental school.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, pulling's easy, right?
You can definitely go to a dental school. It's going to be a little bit more economical, but what you save in money you're paying with in time.
Yeah, and someone with no experience that's fumbling around in your mouth.
Yeah, I mean, the only thing I would let him do is pull it out because that's like, I mean, that's pass fail, right?
Yes, that's either comes out or it doesn't. I'm not going to let you do a nice crown or a nice
crack it, I guess.
Or, that's super rough.
No, I mean, you got some of the best dentists at the state at the University of Maryland Dental School. I mean, I got taught by some of the best guys and gals in the country up there. I mean, some people who's lifelong, this is what they eat, sleep, and breathe. So you're going to get good dentistry there, but it's going to take 3 hours for a 10-minute procedure, you know.
Oh, wow.
So you pay in time.
Let me ask you this. Your name is Alex. You said you've been a dentist for 4 years?
Yes, sir.
What do you make?
I'm not going to say that.
Why? No one knows who you are.
The whole damn state knows who I am. It's a small community.
They'll recognize your voice. They'll get jealous of your income.
Write it down.
Text in a picture. Write it down and text it in.
Do you have...
Well,
I'm just curious.
I'll say this. I have multiple
loans.
Cars. I have multiple cars, and I got multiple boats.
Do you have, I don't like you.
Wow.
I don't like him.
Do
this
you
is
have,
my new dentist.
Do you have multiple practices?
No, I don't have multiple practices, but I left out some important details. I have one car which is about 27 years old with 300,000 miles and is worth about $800. And my other car that I'm driving now is a 20-year-old Toyota.
Hey, Alex, when the office is shut, the office is locked, you guys play around with that gas?
That was my question.
No,
dude.
No, hippie crack. No, yeah. But let me tell you, if you've ever done laughing gas, it will rock your world.
Yeah, hippie crack, baby. Let's
How
go.
Much for
Nitrous
a
Mafia. 3800 Hooper Avenue. Attention, Stamboni, J.
I need a couple balloons. Let's go.